Hello students, welcome in our next session of our poem Topsy Turvy. In this session we are going to learn or see some question and answer of the poem. Look at that question number first. When do children go to school in the Topsy Turvy land? And the answer is, in Topsy Turvy land children go to school at night. They go to school at night. Okay students. Question number 2. In the poem, if buses travel on the sea, then where do the boats travel? In the poem, if buses travel on the sea, then where do the boats travel? How should it rightly be? The boats travel in the streets. Okay, and they should travel on the sea. Okay, like this. Then question number 3. The land of Topsy-Turvy is very different from our land. Let's draw comparison by filling in sentence wherever needed. So here I put the answer for you. Look at that. Topsy-Turvy and our land. First thing, people walk on their heads in Topsy-Turvy land. In our land, people walk on their feet. So this is the comparison. Then the buses run on the sea in Topsy-Turvy land, but in our land the buses run on land. They wear their hats on feet. In case of our land, they wear their hats on head. Okay. Boats sell in streets in Topsy-Turvy land and boats sell in the sea in our land. Then people pay for what they don't get. In case of our land, people pay for what they only get. Okay, so like this, this is a comparison between Topsy-Turvy land and our land. Then let's listen fun with sounds. You have to write the similar sound words. Okay, so let's write pleasure, treasure, measure, creature, right? Then wear, tear, fear, beer. Okay, then swear, swear, wear, care, mare. Okay, then plan, can, scan, strand. Then topsy-turvy, hurly-burly, curly fiddly, wobbly doubly. Okay, like this. Then look at that. Let's talk question number 1. The words in the sentence are jumbled here. Rearrange them to make meaningful sentence. Words that begin with the capital letters are the first of the sentence. Okay, so Renu Naughty is a girl. And the correct order of the word is Renu is naughty girl. Okay. Untidy room her always is. Her room is always untidy. Then third one, mother her advises her clean to it. Her mother advises her to clean it. Then never listen she her to mother to. She never listens to her mother. Then, kind of what child you are? What kind of child you are you? What kind of child are you? So these are the correct orders of the words. Look at that question number 2. Can you tell some things that go topsy-turvy at home and there is a disorder? Yes, we can. We will see which kind of disorder is there. Sometimes some things go topsy-turvy at home. Their list is given below. Let's see what is it. It is time to go to school and you do not find the book that you needed most because the teacher is very strict. So this is the topsy-turvy thing that would happen with us. One of the socks in your hand and the other is missing. You are desperately looking for it. Is it, students? Yes, this thing would happen with us also. Your notebook is in your bag and you are looking for somewhere else. Your notebook is in your bag and you are looking for somewhere else. Okay, students, so these are the things that could happen in our house also. Let's write question number one. Write five things that you do at home to make your home look neat and clean. What kind of things you are doing at home to keep your home neat and clean? Let's write. I arrange my bed every morning. I arrange my bed every morning. I clean my toilet every day. I keep my bookshelves arranged. I sometimes sweep the floor of my study room. Then I always keep my shoes in shoe rack after use. Okay, so we will do these things to keep our house neat and clean. Okay, question number three. Two stories got mixed up. Sort them out and write them in the appropriate boxes. Here, the two stories are mixed with the sentences. We thought the lion had eaten someone. Then second sentence is, suddenly the kite lifted him off the ground and took him over the treetops. He saw a shoe in the lion's cage. Finally, the kite brought him back to the park. Our class had gone to the zoo. Pooran was flying the brand new kite in the park. Some children stood and screamed and some ran to the director of the zoo. Pooran was frightened and excited. The lion had not eaten anyone because the shoe was one of the lion's toy. So these are the jumbled sentence. You have to find out the two stories from these sentences. And the first story is the magic kite. Pooran was flying the brand new kite in the park. Suddenly the kite lifted him off the ground and took him over the treetops. Pooran was frightened and excited. Finally, the kite brought him back to the park. So this is the short magic story or short story of the magic kite. Then about lion, the another story was there. Our class had gone to the zoo. We saw a shoe in the lion's cage. We thought that the lion had eaten someone. Some children stood and screamed and some ran to the director of the zoo. The lion had not eaten anyone because the shoe was one of the lion's toys. So these stories are there with the given sentences. Okay, students, here our question and answer session is finished. Okay, you can write all these question and answer in your notebook. Thank you.